Hello everyone, I'm Norman Wildberger, and we're talking about mathematics and music. I want to move towards understanding and analyzing our staff notation for representing musical notes on a piece of paper, as represented by this thing here. This is a prelude by Johann Sebastian Bach, okay, in the well-tempered clavier, one of the most famous pieces of music collectively ever written. And this one is in a key of D, okay? So there's the treble clef here, there's a bass clef here, and these two sharps that you see at the beginning of the lines are telling us that we're not in the key of C, like this, we're rather in the key of D, which has two sharps, this one and this one. So. Etc. So it turns out that this system of sharps and flats, and the well-tempered clavier is a great example because it has actually pieces in all of the 12 keys, both major and minor. So there's lots of flats and also sharps throughout the works. So this is all based on a certain pattern of key signatures. These are called key signatures. And ultimately, when we think about that, it turns out that the key signatures are intimately connected with properties of scales. So today I want to talk about the remarkable, almost uniform property of the major scale, which is not at all appreciated, not at all appreciated. And it's really a mathematical thing. And we'll see that our mathematical numerical notation really makes accessing the patterns behind the major scale much more more easy, okay, and it brings out what's really going on. So what am I talking about here? The uniform scales that we looked at last time, for example, the two-step uniform scale or the diminished scale, right? They had the property that if you translate them suitably, you basically get the same scale back, especially if you consider the scale as being extended. Okay, so for example, with the diminished scale, if we translate it up by a three-step, one, two, three, then that becomes, which is really the same set of notes, just moved up, but the notes actually are the same. So that's a defining property of these uniform scales that we looked at last time. Now, today I want to look at the major scale. And in an important way, this is almost uniform. That's the interesting property. And that's ultimately really behind, in some sense, this approach that we have to organizing the keys and the various key signatures, etc. So let me explain what that is. So let's start with the piano here and the obvious sort of special scale of the C major scale from here to here, because it just consists of the white notes, okay? So we're just considering these seven white notes and then we're back to the C again. So suppose I take this scale here and I look at various translates of it, okay? So if we translate it up, or in musical terms, transpose it up a single step, a one step, then we get the D flat scale. And we can observe that this scale has mostly black notes, but it does have two white notes, this one and this one. Let's carry on like that and just observe how many white notes each of these scales has as we go up step by step. The next one's D. It has five white notes. Next one's E flat. Has four white notes. Next one's E. Has three white notes. Next one's F. Well, that's sort of interesting because that one only has one black note. And it has, in fact, six white notes. And in fact, the situation is exactly the same if we sort of translate down. So if we go down to the B, we again get two white notes, then B flat. That's five white notes, then A. That's four white notes, A flat. That was three white notes, and then G G also has six white notes. And the one that we haven't covered is the F sharp, which has two white notes. So, out of all of the translates of the major scale, okay, two of them, the five-step transposition or translation and the seven-step transposition or translation, going from C to F, like a perfect fourth, or from C to G, like a perfect fifth. We prefer to call this a five-step and this a seven-step. It's exactly those steps that give us translates or transpositions of the original scale that share all of the notes of the original scale except for just one. So this is an almost uniform scale. And that's a very interesting, rather subtle property of the major scale. How common is that kind of property? So now I want to analyze this phenomena a little bit more mathematically using our numerical notation for tones, okay? So we're looking at the major scale. I want to demonstrate to you that it's almost uniform and also point out that the number 42 is kind of curiously associated with this story. So the interval sequence for the major scale, 2-2-1, 2-2-2-1, we're very familiar with that. Here on the vertical scale, I've put the notes of a major scale starting on some tonic zero, which could be middle C or it could be something else. Okay, so 0, 2, 4, 5, 7, 9, 11. I hope those tones are pretty familiar to you. Those are the tones of the major scale. Separation of 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2. Okay, and then here are the various translates or transposes of this major scale, going up by one each time. Where you can see I'm just adding one, mod 12, so then when I get to 11, the next one is zero. Okay, so this is the C scale, this would be the D flat scale, this is the D scale. And then I'm just circling in these transposed scales the notes which are common with the original scale. Okay, and I see that for the first one, when we've gone up one step, there's two notes in common. Remember when I played the D flat, there was an F and a C, right? There's the F and the C. And then in the next one, which is the D scale, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in common. The next one is the E flat scale, there's 4 in common. The next one is E scale, there's 3 in common. And then we get to the F scale, the scale built on the 5, okay? And we see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 notes in common. All the notes are in common except for that fourth note. That's the critical property that we're interested in. Okay, so that this translate of the original scale by a five step results in another scale which is almost the same as the original one, just differs from it by one note, which on the piano, if you're starting with a C scale, corresponds to adding a black note, either a flat, in this case B flat, or a sharp, in this case F sharp. Okay, the next one is the F sharp scale, just has two, and then up here is the 7 scale built on G, the 7th note, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, again we see 6 white notes, everything except the last note, which ends up having to be replaced with a black key. Okay, so there's a symmetry here because, as we saw on the piano, going up by three steps, going down by three steps, the relations are the same. So it's going to be then repeating 3, 4, 5, 2 as we go to the A flat, the A, the B flat, and the B scales. But crucially, here we have these two sixes, and it's really this property of the major scale, which I think is somewhat interesting. And it's actually quite important if you think about the way our key signatures are organized. They're really quite connected with this phenomena that if you go up a perfect fourth or perfect fifth, in other words, a five-step or a seven-step, then the notes that you are playing in this new transposed major scale are pretty well the same ones that you had previously, except for just one change. So in terms of key signature, you have to add a flat or add a sharp, or maybe subtract one if you're going the other direction. So what happens if we do this for some other scale? For example, the harmonic minor scale with interval sequence 2, 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, 1. Well, here's a scale built on some note 0, 0, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, 11, which has these as the interval sequences. And here are the various translates of this original minor scale. Okay, translate by 1, or transpose by 1, transpose by 2, 3, etc. We're talking about steps. And I've circled all the common tones and recorded in each column the number of overlaps, and hopefully you can check what I've done is correct. And I get 3 overlaps here. Where's 3? There's a 3, 4, 6, 8. The 8 should be circled. Okay, did I do that also over here? Well, here I got 3, okay. So 3 here, 3 here, 5 here, 4 here, 4, 4, 4, 4, 5, 3, and 3. But notably, there are no sixes here, and so the harmonic minor scale does not support this almost uniformity that the major scale had. So for example, if we were, you know, thinking about creating a key signature framework based on a minor scale, it would not be so convenient. So that leads us to think, well, you know, just how common is this particular property of the major scale? But before we go on with another example, I just want to observe one more thing, that if we total the total number of overlaps between the original and all these new ones, the total here is 42. And you can check that it was also 42 for the major scale. And as a fun little exercise, you might like to convince yourself if that's always true or not. So perhaps the problem with that minor scale was that there was a 3-step involved, making it more obviously not so uniform. What if we look at an example where the interval sequence is much the same as for the major scale? It's just a little bit of a variation. So say 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2. Again, 5 twos and 2 ones, but the relative positions are just a little bit different. The ones here are separated by a single 2 and 4 on the outside, and the major scale was 2 and 3. Okay, so here is a scale built on some note 0 with these as the intervals. 0, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8, 10. And here are the various translates. And I've computed the various overlaps. You can check that I've done this right, hopefully. And what's the total, by the way? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 times 4 is 28, plus 10 is 38, plus 4 is 42. So the total is 42 again. But notably, even though this is looking a lot like a major scale in terms of the pattern made by the interval sequence for it, it does not have the property that it has a 6 somewhere. It doesn't have that property. So now a natural question is, okay, so of the various possible scales that we could consider, say with 7 notes, just how many scales or scale types are there that have this almost uniform property? And I don't know. I don't know. So that's perhaps something that some viewers would like to think about and report back to us. So perhaps you can figure it out and see if there are any other examples or if the major scale is unique in this fashion. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.